The WLJC Spring Telethon begins Monday, March 21st at 7 p.m. This is your opportunity to be a part of a special ministry, reaching the world with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Join us each night to hear live gospel music performances, worshiping God in song and truth. Our guest hosts and pastors will be here to read your pledge and pray for you. We want to thank you for your financial support of this ministry. As many of you know, Telethon comes only twice a year, so each Telethon, it's important to reach our goal. WLJC can reach those who won't attend churches or those who aren't able to go to church. For some, WLJC may be their only opportunity to hear the gospel. Your donations can make a difference. Please pray about giving a special one-time gift to this ministry, as well as becoming a monthly financial partner. The WLJC Spring Telethon will be from March 21st through April 2nd at 7 p.m. nightly. Pledge now and support the WLJC ministry. Call 606-464-3600 or 859-402-0673 or go to WLJC.com and click donate. Thank you for all your support and may God bless you.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the hour of harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to the service tonight, our very first night of our spring revival. We're all very excited. We've been praying and looking forward to this night because this is the night we're believing for the Lord to really do something special for each of us. And you know, we all need to be revived from time to time by the presence of the Lord and by the things that He does for us. And so if you have the time, be sure and stay tuned because we are going to have a good service tonight. We're really believing for that. Our very first night of our spring revival. And you know, in our mail, we've been getting some letters and you tell us that you're praying for the revival and the telethon. And also, some of you are sending your telethon gifts already in, and that is very thoughtful and we appreciate it. And if you send in a gift, be sure and let it be known that you want it read on the telethon, if that's where you wanted it to be, is on the telethon to add to the total there. And and also be sure that you have the right address because if it is mailed somewhere else, then that's the end of it. But we'd like for you to write to us and send in your prayer requests and your pledges of support. You know, only twice a year we talk about it. But now, of course, we have our revivals first, and we have people saved during the revivals and during the telethons. And so we appreciate those that are already corresponding with us, and we really appreciate what you're doing and how you're praying for us, because many of you tell us that it is your inspiration. You cannot go to church anymore. Today we heard from someone in North Dakota, and they did not write anything. I'd love to know these people better if they write to us a little, but they just sent a money order for the telethon, and so that's from North Dakota. And so we're reaching a lot of places, and so it's important that we stay alert and stay on the job and do everything we can to get somebody to stop and realize, hey, I might be going in the wrong direction. I need the Lord in my life. Well, we have good singing and preaching tonight, so The one scripture I'm going to share with you right now, and because you'll be hearing more scripture a little later, Brother Fred is here and he's going to get us off to a good start tonight. But in 2 Chronicles 7:14, it says, "If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land." You know, that covers everything in our lives and everything that we need is, and it says, the Lord's saying, if you're called by my name, that's what we as Christians are called. We take his name and said, if we'll humble ourselves and pray and seek the face of God and turn from our wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sins and heal their lands. You know, our land of America definitely needs to do this also, but you know, it's done one at a time, you know, each individual. So let's do what 2 Chronicles 7:14 says. And we have some prayer requests already in, and so we want to, we'll be taking care of all those a little later. But right now we're going to pray and get into the music because we want plenty of time for the music and the preaching because this is our first night of our spring revival. So let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you because you have given us and one more chance to witness for you, to sing for you, to preach, to share, to answer the phones in your name. And whatever we do, we should do it as unto you because we know this is the way that we will be held accountable if we're doing it for you or ourselves or how it goes. So Lord, help us as individuals and as a nation to do what 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, to turn from our wicked ways and seek your face, and then you will, your part is, you said you would heal, forgive the sins and heal our lands. So Lord, we ask for that tonight in each home, each heart that will be viewing tonight. Lord, let miracles take place. Let this be a night that they will long remember that this was when they were really dedicated, sold out to you. And bless our singer and Brother Fred and the phone operators. And Lord, we're going to give you praise in advance for what you're going to do because you promised to be here with us. And we thank you for that in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, tonight we have, as our singer, we have Brother Lonnie King from Ferguson, Kentucky. He does have CDs, and the phone number is 606-875-8230. And so right now, let's welcome Lonnie King.
Last thing I remember was fighting that steering wheel, lying there in pain, broken glass and twisted steel. Someone took me by the hand, said, "You're gonna make it through." I could hear the thunder, I could feel the rain, not knowing if my life would ever be the same. Then a peaceful, easy feeling started coming over me. Was that you, Lord, when I lost all hope? Was that you, Lord, who walked me that rope? Was that you, Lord, knocking at my door? Was that you, Lord, when I needed healing power? Was that you, Lord, there in my darkest hours? Was that you, Lord, Was that you, Lord? Next thing I remember was lying there in that bed. I don't know if he was really there or if he was in my head, but he looked a lot like Jesus. You know, I said the sinner's prayer right then and there. Was that you, Lord? When I lost all hope, was that you, walk for me that road? Was that you, Lord, knocking at my door? Was that you, Lord, when I needed healing power? Was that you, Lord, there in my darkest hours? Was that you, Lord? Was that you? Was that you, Lord? Was that you, Lord? Was that you, Lord? Was that you? Was that you, Lord? Was that you, Lord? You know, oftentimes that's what we ask ourselves whenever we're in situations where our prayers are answered. Was that you, Lord, when we needed you most? It's a pleasure to be here on this first Bible night, and it's always a pleasure to be with Sister Margaret and Brother Don. And tonight we have a Brother Fred. He's one of my favorite pastors that I've heard preach, and he's going to be here tonight with y'all. And my name's Lonnie King, and I'm a singer and songwriter. I do country gospel music. The song that you just heard, it was number two on Cashbox Magazine and or Cashbox Top 100 in January. So the Lord's blessing me with my with my songs. This next song is one I'm going to do for you. It's called Pray Hard and Live Right, and that's what we all need to do. That's what revival's about.
An old man on an Oso box, he said the end is coming and it can't be stopped. He said, all you sinners better get in line. Lift your hands toward heaven, it's repenting time. You need to pray hard and live right. Profess your faith that Jesus Christ. If you've been living wrong and you want to live right, maybe it's time to dedicate your life. And all God's children need to stay in school, go to church on Sunday, and obey God's rules. If you want to wake up in those heavenly lights, you need to pray hard, live right. You need to pray hard, live right. Yeah, you do. We'll be right back.
I heard a preacher on Channel 4. He said, if you're not saved, you'll go to hell for sure. But if you repent, you're gonna be just fine. You know, as long as you're breathing, brother, there's still time. You need to pray hard and live right. Profess your faith that Jesus Christ. If you've been living wrong and you want to live right, maybe it's time to dedicate your life. And all God's children need to stay in school, go to church on Sunday, obey God's rules. If you want to wake up in those heavenly lights, you need to pray hard and live right. You need to pray hard, live right. You need to pray hard, live right. Somebody say amen. There's somebody that gets on my Facebook a lot, and they say, Lonnie, when are you going to be on WLJC? And his name is Billy K. Smith. And Billy K., I really appreciate you, and this song's for you. It's called My Name Is in the Book. I met an old friend today. The years have took their toll. We talked about the years gone by and all the friends we used to know. He said, I've turned my life around. Oh, but look how long that it's took. As he turned to walk away, he said, my name's in the book. My name's in the book. That dress is still the same. I still live by the church. Our family's always praying. I still fish in the water that washed our sins. All you have to do is look. My name's in the book. As he turned to walk away, he said, you know we'll meet again. It might be here in this old world, or it might be Beulah Land. If I am the first to go, I'll be standing by the brook. As he turned to walk away, he said, my name's in the book. My name's in the book. That dress is still the same. I still live by the church. Our family's always praying. I still fish in the water that washed our sins away. All you have to do is look. My name's in the book. And as he laid up there all still and quiet, I couldn't help thinking and remember the last words that my friend. My name. names in the book. The address is still the same. I still live by the church. Well, our family's always prayed. I still fish in the water that washed our sins away. All you have to do is look. My name's in the book. All you have to do is look. My name's in the book. You know, I'm so glad my name's in that book of life. My name's in the book. We all want our name in that book of life. This next song I'm going to do for you is one that it's entitled Forever in the End. Two kids and a bar, long knife and old school desk and a zest for life. They carved their names deep in the grain and wrote love in the middle. And forever in the end. Well, two young lovers in an old pine tree deep in the woods where no one could see. They carved their names deep in the grain and wrote love in the middle. And forever in the end. Love the football team. She was crowned homecoming queen in the yearbook back in 53. They were voted most likely to be a young married couple with a fresh sidewalk that led to the house that they just bought. They took a stick and they scratched in their name, wrote love in the middle and forever in the end. Carved in stone. The good Lord's finally called them home, but it seemed like only yesterday. They used to laugh and they used to play. And they were two kids in a bar, long knife and old school desk and a zest for life. They carved their names deep in the grain and put love in the middle and forever in the end. Forever in the end. Forever in the end. Forever in the end. All right, that's one that a little faster tune. This next song is one I'd like to dedicate to anybody that's lost a loved one, especially a female loved one in the past past year or so. It's a song that's really touched my heart, and it's an Alan Jackson song. Of course, I didn't write this one, but all the other ones that you've been listening to, the Lord's blessed me with being able to write and record those songs. But I hope you enjoy this one. It's called Sissy Song. I'd like to dedicate this to my wife, Margaret. She died not this past November, but the November before that. You know. Why did she have to go so young? I just don't know why. Things happen half the time without reason, without rhyme. Love this sweet young woman, daughter, wife, and mother. It makes no sense to me. I just have to believe she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and past where no one sees. And she walks with Jesus and the loved ones waiting. And I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. Loved one she left behind, trying to just survive, and ask the reasons why, feeling so lost inside, anger shot straight to God, then asking for his love, anger and disbelief, praying that just maybe she flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and past where no one sees. And she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting. And I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. It's hard to say goodbye. Her picture in my mind reminds me of the times I'll cherish and I won't cry. She flew up to heaven on the wings of angels by the clouds and stars and past where no one sees. And she walks with Jesus and her loved ones waiting. And I know she's smiling, saying, don't worry about me. Don't worry about me. Don't worry about me. All right, here's one that's a little, that was too serious, so we're going to have to do one that's not quite so serious. It's one that entitled God's Gated Neighborhood. And one time I saw a Hearst, and then right behind it was kind of a U-Haul trailer. And that's what I sort of wrote this song about. It looked like the Hearst was pulling a U-Haul trailer, which is something that really don't happen, you know. But in my mind, I thought that Hearst was pulling the U-Haul trailer. So listen to the words carefully, and maybe you'll get a kick out of this one. Well, I used to try to keep up with the Joneses down the street, and it seemed like for a little while we had one of everything. We were building up our earthly homes filled with all the frills, when we should have been working on a mansion on the hill. No, there won't be no U-Haul trailers pulling through the pearly gates. All the treasures we've laid up on earth won't be worth a thing. And all the money we put in the bank won't do us no good. No, there won't be no upper class in God's gated neighborhood. No, they won't. No, you won't find a hardware store up in Beulah Lane, 'cause all the homes made in heaven weren't made by human hands. No, you won't find a Kroger or Super Walmart store. Everything will be provided. You won't need them anymore. There won't be no U-Haul trailers pulling through the pearly gates. All the treasures we laid up on earth won't be worth a thing. And all the money we put in the bank won't do us no good. No, there won't be no upper class in God's gated neighborhood. There won't be no U-Haul trailers pulling through the pearly gates. All the treasures we've laid up on earth won't be worth a thing. And all the money we put in the bank won't do us no good. No, there won't be no upper class in God's gated neighborhood. No, there won't be no upper class in God's gated neighborhood. I had a pastor one time, Brother Fred, he said, "You mean to tell me that we're not going to get to play with drills and all that sort of thing?" I told him I didn't say that at all. There'll be all kinds of nice drills and nice electrical toys to play with. So I didn't want to take his dream away. So. Oh, here's the first song that I ever wrote as far as a Christian song goes. It was the night that I got saved. Rededicated my life, which is what we're doing tonight. We're talking about revival, rededication. And I was driving down this old country road, and the Lord let me have this song just all at once. You know, sometimes things will take a while to come to you, and sometimes they won't. But this one was pretty much instantaneous, and it's called Dead End Road. I went searching for those streets of gold, looking for salvation and the holy word. I was down on my luck, nowhere really to go. I guess I was headed down a dead end road. I went walking in no particular direction. I was getting close to the end of life's rope, just about to give up on ever finding redemption. Till I found a little church down a dead end road. I found Jesus down a dead end road. I can feel him with me now wherever I go. Change came over me, it uplifted my soul. Since I found Jesus down a dead end road, I fell down on my knees, cause they started to tremble. The chill fell over me, it was the Holy Ghost. They all shouted hallelujah, he is delivered. Since he found Jesus, oh, he's finally home. I found Jesus down a dead end road. I can feel him with me now wherever I go. A change came over me, it uplifted my soul. Since I found Jesus down a dead end road. I found Jesus down a dead end road. I can feel him with me now wherever I go. A change came over me, it uplifted my soul. Since I found Jesus down a dead end road. I'm so glad I found Jesus down a dead end road. You know, you can find Jesus anywhere. All you got to do is just look. You know, it's just as simple as me talking to Sister Margaret or talking to Brother Fred, Brother Don. You know, it's just real simple. This is a song that I've seen other groups sing, you know, out. And luckily I was tuning in one night and I saw a group sing this song. This is a song that I wrote, and they were singing on Sister Margaret's program. So I don't know, maybe you might recognize the tune. It's called Dirt Won't Keep Me in the Ground. I know this mortal life won't last forever, and no one knows just when the end will come. We might guess and speculate what lies behind those pearly gates. I've been told through faith that heaven's mine. Time may drive another nail in my coffin, and you won't know I ever was around. When this old heart no longer beats, they can bury me, but dirt won't keep me in the ground. No, when Jesus comes for me, you know I'll be waiting. Lying in a sweet and peaceful sleep, but in the twinkling of an eye, I'll see that sweet by and by. What a beautiful moment that will be. And time may drive another nail in my coffin, you won't know I ever was around. This old heart no longer beats, they can bury me, but dirt, it won't keep me in the ground. No, dirt won't keep me, no, dirt won't keep me, no. Won't keep me in the ground. All right. I'm going to do one of my testimonial songs, since this is a night of rededication. This is one of my testimonial songs. It's called I Surrender All. I thought I had all the answers. I thought I knew it all. I turned my back on Jesus every time I heard him call. I was living in the moment, thought time would never end. Took a lifetime to realize that he was my greatest friend. I surrender all and put it in God's hands in no time at all. I became a better man. I was much too weak to stand, way too proud to cross. Oh, my life was going nowhere, so I surrendered all. Now I have some of the answers I didn't have back then. And I worship my sweet Savior. I put all my faith in Him. These days I'm more careful of how I spend my time. My careless days of sinning have all been left behind. I surrender it all, and I put it in God's hands in no time at all. I became a better man. I was much too weak to stand, way too proud to cross. Oh, my life is going nowhere, so I surrendered all. Friend, you know your life is going nowhere, so you surrender all. Are you ready to surrender tonight?
Thank you so much. Amen. Lonnie King from Ferguson, Kentucky. See, the Lord has a job for each of us. Now,
yes.
I'd hate to think I had to write songs. Well, you'd hate to listen to them, wouldn't you?
He makes it simple, though.
Yeah, he just comes easy. Well, God gives us all a job to do and something to do for Him, and so that's great. We appreciate Lonnie and that the fact that he loves the Lord, and mm-hmm. he's got a good praying mom that tried to get here tonight, but she didn't get away from babysitting in time. So, pray for Lonnie and his endeavors in life, and to get in touch with him is 606-875-8230. All right, appreciate him coming tonight. Well, we have, this is Revival Night, first night, and we always like, well, I guess we're a little prejudiced. We always like to have Brother Fred come.
We get that way. You know.
We do. And sometimes we can humble ourselves and admit it, and sometimes we don't. But it just seems like it always goes better if Fred gets things started for us. He's been with the ministry since before it ever went on the air, the TV part. So he knows all the ins and the outs and the good times and the bad times we've had, and yet he still comes and preaches and shares and helps us. And so we appreciate you being here, and just thank the Lord for you. So just take all the time you want to.
Okay, it's a great privilege for me to be here tonight. I count it a great honor to be able to start off in front of all these distinguished, and I really think they are, a group of men that's going to be lining up for these next 2 weeks. And I think they have something to say that needs to be listened to. And so it's always a privilege to start out. I'm going to try to start our revival off tonight with, let me say this before I read my scripture. Lonnie It's good to see Brother Lonnie again. Something made me think of him the other day. I was in my office and found a tape, one of Lonnie's tapes. I've got his tapes in that, and I'm glad to see him tonight. And through all of his struggles and stuff, he's still tugging on for the Lord.
Yes, that's
it's good. Good to see that and hear that. But you know the reason why God wants us to surrender all, and that was Lonnie's last song, and he's talking about surrendering all. You know, God can't fix a whole man with just a portion of what he has. Mm-hmm. If God is going to fix a man, he's got to have all of him. He can't fix a whole man with a partial job. He's got to have the whole man so he can fix everything about him. Because with a man, everything is wrong.
Yes.
Everything is wrong. We aren't proportionally disturbed. We are totally disturbed.
Yes.
Without God, we are totally alienated from God. And so that's why we got to surrender all. You just can't lay a little down. You've got to give God everything. The Bible says, the day you give me your whole heart is the day I'll be found with you. Because God can take a whole heart and he can fix it. God can't take portions and try to build a man. He's got to have something to work with. And with God, it's all. And so tonight, maybe you are ready to surrender all.
Yes.
And in this revival, maybe we can start out tonight by just surrendering all. But I want to start out tonight. This is very familiar scripture. It's found in St. John's Gospel, chapter 14. And I want to preach something tonight that all of us will agree on. You cannot, and I'm going to say this and not be rude in any way, but tonight you cannot disagree with what I'm preaching and be a Christian. You can't be a good Baptist, good Methodist, good Pentecostal, a good anything unless you agree with what I'm preaching tonight. Because what I'm preaching to you tonight is the Word of God. And it is very familiar scripture, but I'll quote a lot of it, but I really want to read to us in verse 6. And Jesus, this is what we are all about. This is where we're all headed. This is what we all have our minds on. This is going to be our end. I mean, what Sister Margaret and Brother Lonnie and I have done here tonight doesn't have any meaning if this doesn't have any meaning. There's no reason for us to be here without this. Every time I read this, I'll never forget this. But Jesus said this. I'll start off reading this. Let not your hearts be troubled. God does not want troubled hearts. A troubled heart is a breeding ground for controversy. And God doesn't want that in his children. Let not your hearts be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. One night many years ago, sitting on this set, Brother Freeman Saylor and I was sitting here. And we had the Bible open to St. John chapter 14. That night, Brother Freeman Saylor was very troubled. He had overheard a man preaching that God had not promised us a mansion. And he said the guy told him that he literally said, we were just going to have a living place. And he said, Brother Fred, what do you think about that? And I told him, I said, Brother Freeman, I said, it really don't matter. Heaven is going to be heaven. But you know what? If the Bible says that there's going to be a mansion over there, then we'll just believe for it.
Yes, we'll just stand
on what it said. Many call it dwelling places. Many calls it a place of abode. But I'll tell you what, I'll just take it like the old King James said, and in my Father's house are many mansions. I'll go away and prepare one for you. Now, if you get up there and it's not a mansion compared to this earth, you still won't be disappointed because it will be heaven.
Yeah.
And so Jesus said, in my Father's house are many mansions. I go away and prepare a place for you. We will all agree on that. Everybody that preaches here this week will tell you that we agree together on that. And just the cotton patch virgin to get down to where I want to preach on tonight. And Jesus was talking about a place where he was going to go. And I'm going to go away and prepare a place for you. The disciples was a little perplexed. And Thomas and some of them was there. And they said, Lord, we don't know where you're going. And we don't know the way. And we don't understand all of this stuff that you're saying to us. And then Jesus goes down to verse 6. And the Bible said, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. If you are a reader, an advocate reader of the book of John, you will find that in the book of John, Jesus gives us seven I ams. And you know, the wonderful thing about this gospel and the wonderful thing about following Jesus Christ is this. It's not that he was, and it's not that he is going to be. But the thing about Jesus is he am all the time. And that's what makes him God. He am all the time. And as long as he is, and as long as I am, he will always be, and he will have always been. And Jesus said something here to him that we need to listen to tonight. I am sitting on this stage tonight preaching to you the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And I am preaching tonight that Jesus is the way. I am preaching to you tonight that Jesus is the truth. And I am preaching to you tonight that Jesus is the life. Now, I'm preaching tonight, I am preaching there is a way. I'm a preaching that there is a truth. I'm a preaching that there is a life because I'm only a vessel and I'm preaching away. And the thing about it is when Jesus was sitting with them, Jesus said, I'm not preaching away. I'm not preaching a truth. Jesus said, I am the way. Now that is what is so wonderful about Jesus Christ. And that is, he's the way. On my way tonight down here, I overheard the people on the television talking about the presidential election. They was promising. They was talking about a way they wanted for the American people. They was talking about the things they wanted to do for the American people. But you know something? In all of the things that I hear them talking about, I never hear them mention the gospel. I never hear them mention Jesus. I never hear them mention anything about this good old gospel way. All I heard them say is, this is the way that we want to go. Guys, let me tell you something tonight. I am telling you that Jesus is the way. The Bible says that the way is narrow on the way to heaven. Why? Because so many people choose not to go there. But still yet, Jesus said, I am the way. You know, this evening, many people are heading in many directions. Lonnie was singing about the end of a one-way street or at the end of the road where he met Jesus. Well, Jesus told his disciples, even at the end of that, that I'm going away and I'm going to fix a place for you. There's a place, you know, seems like in the last 2 weeks, we have lived in a nursing home. We've been preaching loved ones' funerals that have served God and lived for God and loved God all the days of their life. And this weekend in the last 2 weeks has been the end of their road. Their life ended in the fact that Jesus went away and he prepared a place for us. If it wasn't that God has not gone away and prepared a place for us, then we wouldn't have a reason to be here tonight. The reason I'm here tonight is because Jesus said, I've gone away and I'm preparing a place for you that where I am, you may be also. That is encouraging. That is what I live for. A man was asking me on the phone today, said, preacher, how long have you been preaching? You know, when it hadn't dawned on me for years. I told him, almost 40 years. I've been carrying this gospel for almost 40 years. I never realized that.
But you know, everything that I've done for 40 years is based on the fact that Jesus has gone away to prepare a place for me. Yes. That where He is, I can be also. And because where He is, and because He is the great I am, I can have life and have it more abundantly. Glory to God. I can have a life. When this life is over, Lonnie and I was talking about growing older and having this pain and that pain and this hurt. Well, let me tell you something tonight. Everything in this life is fading away, and the fading into the darkness of a forever. And I'm glad to that my forever is in the glorious land with Jesus. Oh, I'm glad that when my life is over and when this life is done, I'm going to be at eternity with Jesus. Mm-hmm. You know, as we grow older and as our bodies fade away and as time grows on us. You know, tonight Brother Bill is sitting back there tonight. He's back with us tonight, praise God. But he's got his oxygen tank. His lungs don't work as good as they used to. But Jesus said, in my Father's house are many mansions. In my Father's land is a place where you won't need oxygen. In my Father's place is a house to where you won't never have to worry about anything anymore. And I don't know about you tonight, but glory to God, it's sounding better every day.
Yes.
It's sounding more glorious every day. Mm-hmm. And Thomas said, Lord, Philip even asked him one day, God, where are we going? What is the way? Jesus said, boys, I am the way. You know something, Sister Margaret? That really simplifies things.
Yes,
if he said, well, now let me explain something to you. The way is somewhere down here in Tennessee. The way is somewhere in Ohio. The way is over in Missouri somewhere. The way is this direction or that direction. But Jesus said, I'll explain it to you as good as it can be explained. If you're looking for a way from heaven, then here I am. Mm. I am the way. Now, Sister Margaret, that is something that anybody ought to be able to get a hold of.
Yes.
There's no crooked roads. You really don't need a tom-tom, or you don't need anything else. All you need to understand that Jesus said, I'm the way.
Yes.
Then if the way is Jesus, Pastor, what do I need? Then the only thing you really need is to know Jesus.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Amen.
You know, I'm going to tell you something tonight, and don't get me wrong, but you know what we've stood for here at this station for the years that I've been here and all the years that it's been here is for the fact that we are an exclusive group of people. And what I'm really saying is this. We aren't arguing with the world. We're not fighting. We're not here to fight with the world. And I heard the people say, like Oprah and many other people say, you know, I believe that there's many ways to heaven, and we believe that this religion will get you there and that religion will get you there. Well, the difference in us and the difference in everybody else is we're not looking for a way. We're not trying to find peace in our soul. We're not trying to find tranquility on our way home. But what we are looking for is this, and we have a Savior, and His name is Jesus.
Yes.
And He has made a way for us. And that's why we can't take no other way. That's why we can't receive no other path. That's why we can't go in no other direction, because Jesus said, I'm the way.
Mm-hmm.
Almost 40 years ago, I found Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Sister Margaret, He's been good ever since.
Yes.
I haven't needed another Savior. I haven't needed another way. I haven't needed another avenue. I haven't needed more peace. I haven't had to have a better kingdom. I haven't had to have more solution and better answers to all of my problems. The night I met Jesus, hallelujah.
Yes.
The night Jesus became my Savior. The night Jesus became the Lord of my life. I no longer needed any more antidote. I no longer needed another pill. I got the gospel. I no longer needed another way. I found the way.
Yes.
And His name was Jesus.
Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
And then He looked at them again and He said, boys, I'm not only the way, but I'm the truth. So many people tonight are looking they're studying, they're going to colleges, they're going to universities. We're trying to find new ways and new ideas about truth, trying to wonder what truth is. I got a book the other day, a new book I was reading on it called The New Absolutes. And you know, today we're living in a land to where the truth of the gospel is no longer is loved or cared for. We're trying to find a new way. We're trying to find, and all we talk about in America today, that's going to be our downfall. All you hear people say is we have rights. All over this country today, we have this group looking for rights and that group looking for rights. And we've got the college kids saying we've got a right to do this. And we've got women saying we've got a right to do this and we've got a right to do that. And we've got men saying we have rights. And what about our rights? And what about our privileges? And what about our freedoms? And many years ago, the King of Kings come. And when he came into the earth, Jesus said, I'm going to give you something better than rights. I'm going to give you something better than anything. I'm going to give you truth. And I'm going to tell you what the truth is, knowing that I am God and besides me there is none other. And I'm going to give you some good ways and some good truths. You know something, tonight the Ten Commandments has been driven out. And they've been driven out of the courthouses, the schools and everything else. Ever since the day we've drove them out of our schools, took them off of our walls. In Breathitt County tonight, we're fighting for a little picture that a woman drew us many years ago and hung on the courthouse. And it's just talking about Breathitt Countyans believing in God. Someone a few thousand miles away found out we had it. Come to the courthouse one day and looked at it and said, I don't want that up there. Thing about it is, he didn't even put it up there.
No.
But he wanted it down. And so they filed a lawsuit. And he was in Oregon. And he called us up and he said, your picture is offending me. It's offending all of us people who don't love God and all of us who don't love truth. Well, you know, here's the thing about it. Jesus said, if you want to go to heaven, if you want to go where I am, and you know something tonight, this is a sad statement, but Sister Margaret, it's true. God ain't going to make nobody go to heaven.
No.
God is not going to force anybody to go to heaven. Jesus said, I have made a way for you. I am creating the way. And if you want to come to heaven, you can come.
Yes.
But there's something the Bible said that you've got to do. The New Testament teaches us that we cannot go to heaven unless we love the truth.
True.
Now, that's what the Bible says. If you do not love truth, the Bible said all of these good things are held up in store for those who love the truth. Who is the truth? Well, Jesus said, boys, the thing about it is it's not like Diogenes and it's not like all of the Eastern mysticism of religions and the cults of the day, and it's not like all of those. Jesus said, listen, I am the truth. And Jesus said, all of you who have my words in you will have my life. All of you that have my word, that when my word abides in you, if you abide in me and I in you, if my word abides in you, then you have my life abiding in you, Jesus said. And so Jesus looked at his disciples and he said, you know what? I'm the truth. And you know, tonight you can look anywhere you want to, but the Word of God is the truth. The Bible is the truth. And you know something? It's not a harsh command. My son was preaching for me not too long ago, and he said, you know, he said, ain't it amazing? If Jesus Christ is not true, if he's not the truth, how come a plastic Jesus sitting in a courtyard, in a courthouse, in front of a church, in front of a nativity. If a plastic Jesus stirs up every demon in hell, then that sure gives us an understanding.
Yes.
That
yes.
God is true.
Yes, yes.
Just a little lamb laying in a courtyard has stirred up every demon in hell. Just the thoughts of the ancient patriots. You know, Isis, just the thought of the book of Jonah. Just the thought of Jonah's ministry to Nineveh stirred up Isaac so much that they went into northern Iraq the other day and destroyed the tomb of Jonah. They not only, Sister Margaret, destroyed the tomb of Jonah, but they blew it up. They blew it away. And they said, before we leave here today, we don't want anybody to ever know that there was a prophet by the name of Jonah. And so you see, the demons in hell are screaming today. They're screaming in the hearts of men and women that know not God and know not the truth. And here's what we're saying to you tonight. That's what this revival in Babel is about tonight. Listen, man doesn't have the answer. Man doesn't have the answer. Jesus is the answer. And Jesus said, I am the truth. Yes. And I am the way. And let me tell you something tonight. Let me finish this off tonight in a glorious way. Jesus said, if I'm the way and if I'm the truth, then the conclusion of all matters is this. I am the life. I'm the way, the truth, and the life. Now, I don't know what some of you understand tonight, but whether you believe me or not, and you know, some Christians tonight are getting so charismatic, they don't think they're going to die. They really don't. A fellow told me the other day he didn't believe. He said, the reason I don't go to the funeral home, he was a visit though, he said, I don't believe in dying. You know? And I thought, well, that's wonderful. You know, glory to God. You know, he said, I don't believe in dying, you know. Well, I don't either. But the thing about it is, you know, I may not believe in gravity, but it's holding me down.
Yes.
You know, that's the truth about it. I may not believe in the law, but if I'm doing 80 mile an hour down the hill tonight, they're going to pull me over. And whether I believe in them or not, they're going to write me a ticket. Now, here's another thing about it. Whether you believe in it or not, one of these days, you're going to die. And here's what I'm offering you tonight. Amen. Here's what I'm offering you tonight. I met a man one time that says, even though you die, I'll give you life.
Yeah,
I love a story about Mary and Martha. And Lazarus was dead. They took him out and they laid him in a graveyard. And he was already disintegrated. And his body was already going back to the earth. And the earthworm was eating his body. And Jesus come walking down that old dusty road. And the girls run out. One of them run out and fell down at his feet and said, Lord, if you'd have been here, my brother would not have died. And Jesus said, girls, you know the thing about it is, I am the resurrection and I am the life. If your brother believes on me, yet he's dead, he'll always live.
Yes.
Man, what a thought. What a story. Jesus. The story was Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead. But here's what Jesus said. If you believe on me, oh, glory to God. I remember the night. How many of you remember the night that you believed on the Lord?
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I do, Don.
Yes.
I remember the night I believed on the Lord. Glory to God. I remember the night with the drunkenness running through my veins, with drugs running through my veins. Hallelujah. I remember the night that old woman put her arm around me and said, Lord, this is my little boy. Would you please save him? I'll never forget the night that the Holy Ghost entered my body. The life of God entered my body and drugs went out of my system. Alcohol went out of my system. I'll never forget the night that I stood up from a chair and I looked around and Sister Margaret, it was a brand new world. It was a brand new life that I was living in. And you know the thing about it was, I never will forget this. Man of God was preaching at church one night, said his daddy was 84 years old. His daddy fell down one night, gave his life to the Lord. He got up crying, tears running down his face, run over him, hugged his son, and had preached the night that his daddy got saved. Lord, I feel the Holy Ghost in here tonight. And he run over and hugged his son and said, son, he said, I'm 84 years old. And he said, I'm looking around at all of these people and all of this world. And he said, son, God has changed all them people and God has changed all of that world for me. And his son hugged his dad and said, daddy, no, God ain't changed them people and God ain't changed the world. Dad, tonight God's changed you.
Oh, hallelujah.
God has come here tonight to change you. God has come here through the Holy Ghost and the person of Jesus Christ to change you. And you can say tonight, that old man is gone. That old man has passed away. Why? Because tonight I've been introduced to the way, the truth, and the life. Oh, Lord, have mercy. I'll never forget the night. Sister Margaret, I don't believe people don't get saved anymore. They don't anymore. They don't get saved. It seems like they just want to come to the house of God and thank you. Praise God. Amen. When I get teared up, I get ready to preach. Amen. And, you know, it seems like they just come wanting relief. You know, life is hard on people and they'll try this and they'll try that. And God's just another one of those things that they want to try to have relief. But I don't believe in relief.
No.
I believe in change.
Change, yes.
You know, I believe in conversion. I believe God will change you. I believe God come to change you.
Yes.
And I'm going to finish up tonight with this. He can change your life. And listen, here's how he can do that. You got to know him. You got to know him. His name is Jesus. And he come to seek and save you that are lost. And I believe I'm talking to some tonight. I believe some of you tonight said, Pastor, I'd sure like to be saved. Well, tonight's a good night to be that way.
Yes.
Tonight's a good night to change. And so I'm starting our revival out with this. In my Father's house are many mansions. How can I be in that mansion, Pastor? I go away to prepare a place for you. How can I get there? Jesus said, I'm the way. Would you accept him right now? Let me pray with you. Yes. Father, in the name of Jesus, someone is hearing your voice right now.
Yes.
Somebody is believing on Jesus. Father, tonight, would you please convict their heart?
Yes.
And Lord, would you change their heart? Yes. And as Romans 9:10-9 said, I'll believe in my heart, confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus, and we shall be saved. Would you do that tonight? Call. The girls are waiting. All of those prayer partners are waiting tonight up there for you. Why don't you call? And we'll have time maybe to read your name. Sister Margaret.
Yes. Well, that's wonderful. Everything was so truthful and right from the Word. And so you have your Bible. You can read what he has preached. That's wonderful. The Lord always uses Brother Fred to bring the truth out. And, you know, talking about trials and troubles, well, I doubt if there's anybody listening that's gone through more than what Brother Fred has in the last several years. But, you know, you see what it has... It's made him more Christ-like. Now, he didn't want any of the things that's happened to him, but God has sustained him. And that is a testimony within itself. I was talking to a relatively young couple in the hospital yesterday, I believe it was, and saying, I don't know why you haven't been healed, but I do know that God is faithful. God hears her prayers, he heals, he delivers, but there are a lot of things that happens in between, and when you really surrender your life to the Lord, then there's no problem for him to be able to just heal you and deliver you, and so that's what we hope you will do. I believe we have time for a couple of more songs.
Sing Amazing Grace.
Yeah, someone wanted to hear Lonnie sing Amazing Grace, so he probably knows that. That's relatively new, but he can probably figure it out. And
knowing Lonnie, he can write a few verses.
Well, yeah, he can head it. So anyway, we'll be right back to pray with you all on all these requests. There's some of them really serious. Okay.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior, has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains. Unending love, amazing grace. And there's your amazing grace. I'm going to do a song here for you that I really like it. This isn't my song, and I wish it was. I'd be a millionaire. But anyway, you know, revival is about your relationship with God and making it stronger. And this song pretty much says it all. It's a Josh Turner tune, and it's entitled Me and God. And there's no better team than you and God. You know, no matter who you are, if you've got God on your side, you're a winner already. There ain't nothing we can't do, me and God. There ain't no one to come between me and God. Someday we're gonna live where the angels trod, me and God. Early in the morning, talking it over, me and God. Late at night, talking it over, me and God. I guess you could say we're like two peas in a pod, me and God. He's my Father, He's my friend, the beginning and the end. He rules the world with a staff and rod. We're a team. I am weak, but He is strong, me and God. He forgives me when I'm wrong, me and God. Oh, He's the one I lean on when life gets hard, me and God. He's my Father, He's my friend, the beginning and the end. He rules the world with staff and rod. We're a team, me and God. He rules the world with staff and rod. We're a team, me and God. Yeah, we're a team. me and God.
So much, Lonnie. We're getting some calls and talking about how they have enjoyed the songs, and I'm sure that there are much more happened that we haven't heard from. Mm-hmm. They're complimenting the songs, and they really, really needed the songs, they said, tonight. And so we have a lot of requests here, some that we want to mention. Here's someone has a mass on the kidneys doing CAT scan tomorrow, but tell Brother Fred we love him and his brother. Here's from Madison County, a 13-year-old that has cancer. From Irvin, an 18-year-old is on life support, has enlarged heart. From Harlan, Alina is on dialysis at home, has been in the hospital for heart bypass, is in ICU in South Carolina, needs a miracle and wants Brother Fred to pray. Mm-hmm. From Powell County, a great-granddaughter needs prayer, only 2 pounds of weight, and she's very critical. From North Carolina, Gary has some surgery tomorrow, and he has leukemia and other problems there. Somerset, there's several family members there. Urgent request for a scan on the lungs tomorrow, and that's from Madison County. Perry County, Shirley has been diagnosed with melanoma. Here's a lady that's pregnant and has a virus. A great-grandmother's called for a 6-year-old great-granddaughter that's having breathing problems. And here's Catherine, I guess it is, in Central Baptist Hospital with the flu and COPD. Here's from Madison County. Gladys has had a heart attack and heart surgery needed. From Morgan County, someone that's had a family breakup and needs comfort from that. Here's Roberts had surgery on his leg, and here's another one having surgery soon. Vicky has cancer, and here's an 87-year-old tonight, Bonnie from London, and said that was excellent preaching. And so she was amening that. All right, Brother Fred, there's the oil. And so we're going to...
Amen.
Yes.
Father, so many needs in this stack tonight. But Father, they're not a piece of paper. They are people.
No, that's right.
They're your children.
Right,
and cancer is wrecking some of their bones and bodies and tumors and COPD, and many of them having trouble breathing. Little babies born in this world, Father, tonight just need the spirit of life upon them.
Yes.
And we pray for the anointing of God just to go where they are. We send the word tonight, Father, from this place that they would be healed and they would be set free. Lift them up, Father. God, you can. And the Bible said where two or three are gathered together in your name, you'll be one in the midst. So, Father, bring healing and restitution in Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
And amen.
All right. Well, here's one you will want to see. See that little orange, yellow mark up
well,
there?
Praise God. Amen. Well, it looks like Ruth tonight from down in Clay City has rededicated her life to the Lord. Amen.
Yes, yes.
And
yes.
So, Ruth, welcome home.
Yes.
I can promise you there's a mansion waiting on you in heaven tonight.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God.
Okay. Brother Bill Wesley, you know, he usually comes on Monday nights. Well, here it says, he called in, and he's had a tough time with a virus and a partial collapsed lung and pneumonia, and he needs a healing.
Yes, amen.
And so,
So
if you want to just pray another again for him, because...
You know, Sister Margaret, when like Brother Bill, he's a worker here.
Mm-hmm.
And he's been attacked because we got work to do for the next little while.
Yes.
And Satan don't want Bill Wesley or nobody else here. Amen. He don't. And so let's pray for Brother Bill tonight.
Yes.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for Pastor Bill Wesley. God, we just pray for the anointing of God to touch him right now.
Yes.
Father, that's going through this television. Father, inflate that lung to fail no more.
Yes.
Pneumonia, in the name of Jesus, you've got to dry up and die.
Yes.
You're a foreign entity in his body. And in the name of Jesus, by his stripes, we were healed.
Yes.
And Father, for Brother Bill Wesley and for the work ahead and for what you've called him to do tonight, raise him up, Jesus.
Yes.
Raise him up.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. All right. Well, I believe that it's, I believe that many things have happened that we probably won't even know about in this world. But, you know, the word says that he watches over his word to perform it. So the word has been preached. It's gone out around the world tonight. Those people in North Dakota that we heard from today, and in South Carolina, and all of these places we hear from, they have gotten the word tonight. That's what is so thrilling.
Yes.
See, it takes sometimes it takes every ounce of energy you got to get where you're going for a service.
Mm-hmm.
But it's going to be worth it. It's going to be worth it.
That's
and,
right.
All right. We have 3 minutes.
Well, you know, tune in, and we got other good preachers coming up. I'm sure that I enjoy them. I really do. I'm a little different than a lot of people. You know, I don't think everybody should be alike.
No, that'd be boring.
And I don't like alike preachers, you know. And what's what I like about every night you'll hear all of these wonderful mountain preachers and people from all over the country. And they're none all exactly alike.
Mm-hmm.
But there's one thing of that they do, and they bring you the Word of God.
Yes, yes.
They bring you the Word of God. And so stay tuned. Be praying for our telethon that's coming up and for the revival. I feel like God really blessed tonight.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, this ain't the last night, and we're not the only ones.
No, true.
Amen. and we appreciate it, and I thank God just to get to be a part of it. That's all there are to it, amen. And I know these men that's preaching down through these next 2 weeks, they're good men.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
They're good men.
Yes.
And I want to hear what they got to say.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Yes. Well, we appreciate those that have been telling us that you're praying for the revival and telethon. And so see this one soul saved tonight. And I'm sure many others was blessed and rescued. You know, if you're really down and discouraged, you need something to lift you up. And like some of the calls that came in, they have been revived tonight. They have been encouraged and given a little more strength to go a few more miles. And so that's what it's all about, is staying encouraged in the Lord. And you know, regardless of what we go through, I've said this over the years, there is nothing or no one worth you losing your soul for.
That's right.
So whatever it takes for you to get right and stay right with God, do it. Because it's your eternal soul that is at stake, along with a lot of others that you will influence either for good or bad.
That's right.
So anyway, we got a big job to do, and we're going to have the help of the Lord. We're going to do it, aren't we?
That's right. Get her done.
Yes. All right. Thanks so much for everyone that's come to help us. And from all of us, good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including The Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call 606-464-3600 or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy and it's free. May God bless you.